guys, welcome back to Astronaut. In the last video, we briefly discussed the flux-luminosity equation. Today, we're going to go over it in more detail. What's the difference between flux and luminosity? Let's start with luminosity. Unlike streetlights, which require LED lights, stars have the unique ability to produce their own power. This is what we call luminosity, the intrinsic power a star generates. The intrinsic part is important because it means luminosity is independent from where you are in space relative to the power source, the star. This differs from flux, which is entirely dependent on where you are situated. Flux is the amount of power that passes through a given area. The flux experienced from a random point in space, then, is just the fraction of the luminosity that hits it, which would be equivalent to the luminosity divided by the surface area of a sphere that radiates out to the distance of that point in space. Since the surface area of a sphere is 4 pi times the radius squared, we can say that the flux is equal to luminosity divided by 4 pi times the distance squared, where the distance between the star and the point is equal to the radius of the sphere. Consider a streetlight. If there is an 80-watt LED light inside, the streetlight will generate 80 watts of power regardless of whether or not there are observers. A fly swarming 2 meters away will experience a flux from the light bulb of 80 watts divided by 4 times pi times 2 meters squared, which is 5 divided by pi watts per square meter. This flux indicates the level of brightness the fly will experience. If the fly moves in closer to the light by a meter, will the flux be greater or smaller than before? And by how much? The new flux will be 80 watts divided by 4 times pi times 1 meter squared, or 20 divided by pi watts per square meter. The fly's distance was halved, but it experienced a flux 4 times greater at 1 meter away than it did at 2 meters away. This phenomenon is what is called the inverse square law. The flux is related to the inverse square of a distance to an object. So if the fly moves back to twice the distance it was before, it will experience a fourfold decrease in flux. We can prove this by plugging in the numbers. At twice its original distance from the streetlight, the fly will be 4 meters away from an 80-watt power source, so it will experience a flux of 80 watts divided by 4 times pi times 4 meters squared. 4 squared is 16, and 16 times 4 is 64, so it will experience a flux of 1.25 divided by pi watts per square meter, which is 4 times less than the original flux the fly experienced. With a luminosity of 3.8 times 10 to the 26th watts, the sun is a much more powerful source. If Saturn is about 1.5 trillion meters from the sun, what solar flux do we experience? Well, if we plug in all the appropriate numbers, we get approximately 13.4 watts per meter squared. What flux does Jupiter experience if it is about twice as close to the sun as Saturn is? Well, the flux should certainly be greater than the flux experienced by Saturn. By the inverse square law, if Jupiter is half the distance to the sun as Saturn is, it should experience a flux that is 4 times greater than Saturn experiences. So the flux from the sun on Jupiter is about 13.4 watts per meter squared times 4, or 53.8 watts per meter squared. Thanks for watching, guys, and tune in next time to hear about the magnitude scale.